One of my favorite tools in HubSpot is the templates tool. It helps you standardize your communication and saves you a ton of time.
Welcome to HubSpot Hacks, where we help you get more out of HubSpot.
The templates tool from HubSpot is a great way to create and utilize templates right inside HubSpot or your Gmail inbox that replace that repetitive email that you're writing over and over every single day. So let's dive in and put this tool to work. So I'm inside a contact record right now, and I'm going to show you what this looks like before we even dive into the templates themselves. So if I were to write an email, I'm going to use this record because this happens to be my personal record here. And inside of this interface here, you're going to see that as I write an email, there's this templates tab right up here at the top. When I open this templates tab, you can see that I have a variety of templates that are set up that I can choose from, and I can search the templates according to different keywords, according to how I named them. But this templates tool then makes it possible for me to select one of these, and it quickly populates right here inside of this, this email window. So, but I'm gonna take you to a portal that, this is our free test portal, so you can actually see inside of this test portal how this looks to someone who doesn't have the paid version of the tool. So inside HubSpot Free, you get 5 templates, and those 5 templates then max out, and you'll be asked to upgrade if you wanna take advantage of more. So inside this test portal, you're gonna go to Conversations, and Templates is where you're gonna find this. And if you've never set this up before, your template screen here is going to be blank. So we're gonna start just creating one template. And I'm gonna pull this open. So you have the option to create it from scratch or from the template library. So when you're creating a template from scratch, what that means is, let's say that I have an email that I always send to someone when I'm requesting a meeting or maybe to confirm a meeting, I might actually have that already saved in a Word doc, and I just wanna go find that Word doc and I wanna paste it in here and create it from scratch. Or HubSpot has put together a template library, and you can use these as a way to kind of jumpstart and get started with your templates. So here I have share a helpful resource, an inbound lead from content. So again, if you know, hey, someone visited our website and downloaded, some of these here are personalization tokens, which we'll get to in just a second. These follow-up emails. So again, if you're feeling like I wanna get started with templates, but I'm not quite sure where to start, these templates in the HubSpot template library will kind of give you some ideas of ways that you could use templates to kind of get things set up in your library, at least at first. So we're gonna just select this next step email and show you what this looks like. And I'm gonna save my selections. So now that I did this, the next step email is actually the title that HubSpot gave it inside of their template library. So if I'm gonna go in here and change this, I'll just click on that next step email. So again, the name is the next step email. When you send this to a person, they don't see that name. That name is just for you and your team. What they see is this subject line. So the subject is update, question mark. And then hi, right here we have a personalization token. So since you're emailing people inside a customer relationship management tool or CRM like HubSpot has, you're actually gonna be able to use pieces of their contact record to personalize your communication here inside HubSpot. So let's say that in addition to using their company name or their first name, I wanted to use their company name. So let's say I personalize this to say, after our last conversation about, and then I insert, I'm gonna look for a token here, and I'm gonna insert company name. So then it appears here, and since it's in orange, that's gonna be a personalization token, and that gets filled in from the piece of that contact, or that piece of that information inside their contact record. I'm gonna click save this template, and then again, it's still called the next step template. So let's say I wanted to save this template, something that I knew what it meant. This is a really important step. If it's just you and you're just creating templates for yourself, you might be able to figure out this naming thing pretty easy. But if you have a team, you certainly want to put together a naming convention that allows anybody on your team to know what template they're looking for. So if this is called hello and someone else steps into the template library, they might wonder what hello is. So let's go ahead and you probably want to name it something that's going to be easy for your team to know what's in there. And then a last piece here is if you're sharing these, you wanna make sure that if it's, again, if it's something that only I use, I wanna make sure it's not shared with my team so it just shows up in my template library. But if other people on your team need to use it, make sure it is shared. And then lastly, if you get to the point that you're doing a lot more, where you're upgrading beyond that free and you have more templates to work with, you're gonna get a lot of them. And so think about them like your closet. You're gonna need to have some drawers to put things in. So think about this as your folders. You might have sales folders, you might have customer service folders, you might have, I don't know, event specific folders, meeting folders. So if I were to create a folder here and name this, let's say I'm gonna name it follow-up templates, that might be an easy way to get started. So I'm gonna click again, save this template. And then you'll see that because I'm in the free version on this demo, I've created 1 out of 5 templates. And if I upgrade to sales starter, I obviously get a lot more templates. So I'm gonna jump back over to my portal and show you exactly what this looks like and the types of templates that we've created. So here in this screen, again, we're in the contact screen. Under conversations, if I go to templates, I can actually access all of these templates that we've created. So right here, I've got one that isn't shared with anybody else, but it's called Ally Sales Templates. These are templates that I've created. They often follow up after a meeting. They might reach out and request a coffee meeting. They might reach out and request a phone call. They're little things that I've figured out that have worked for me, but I'm not necessarily gonna be something that I share with the rest of the team. Now we also have other things in here like some client onboarding emails. We have a process called the blueprint. So when someone gets into our blueprint process, these are the emails that anybody on our team is gonna be sending them. So here in email, again, I can select a template like we just talked about. And under templates, I'm gonna use a pretty common application of the templates, and that's to confirm a meeting. So we've got this template loaded with information that basically confirms that, you know, we've said we're gonna have a call on this date. Here's the agenda. It's a very consistent type of meeting in this case for us, where we're talking about the same type of information relative to a sales opportunity. So I click select on this email and the subject line is confirming our call. So you'll notice even though I used a template, I can still change the subject line here if I wanted to, and it might be confirming our Zoom call if I happen to use Zoom, or you know, whatever, if I just put meeting here. So you can still customize that. It did use the customization token, so it inserts the first name. And then here you'll notice the time is open because we went ahead and said, okay, you can add the time in, and that's a flexible piece. So I'm gonna put the time of that meeting. And then again, this brief agenda is here because this is the same agenda we use for every contact or for every confirmation call for a connect call. So I would go ahead and click send, or I can send later, which is scheduling it based on a predetermined time according to, you know, time zones and things like that. So to jump back over to templates, again, you get 5. So where I'd recommend you start is you think about the 5 templates that you might, what are you finding yourself copying and pasting multiple times over and over again? It's probably gonna be things like confirming meetings, reaching out for the first time, following up on a referral, really spend time on paper to put those down first before you jump into the templates. And then once you're in here, if you go to create a template from scratch, think about all of the different tokens that we have for personalization. So you might not have information in all of these, but if you wanted to put in, if every person that's in your CRM, you capture their favorite hobby, you could use that in your templates. So go in there and create those and really fill them out. Now, the last piece I'm gonna show you is the templates are also available right in your Gmail inbox, which is awesome. So if you've gotten the Gmail and HubSpot integration, which we have a video that shows you how to set up your Gmail inbox and link it to HubSpot, if you've done that, you can actually then open this new mail message. You can see that my HubSpot and Gmail integration is live because I've got this little bar here in the middle. So if I type in a recipient, so again, I'm gonna send it to the contact I was telling you about. I'm gonna click on templates, and inside here, look at that. I've got the confirmation call template here. I'm gonna click select, and then I can go ahead and use that template right here in Gmail and send it right from my Gmail screen. I don't even have to go into HubSpot. It'll log it, and it's really nice and easy to use. Thanks for watching. For more HubSpot hacks, how-tos, and tips, make sure and subscribe to this channel. We have new videos coming out each week. And if you have any comments or questions, make sure and drop a comment below. We read every single comment and maybe we'll include it in a future video.